Hello friends, I am Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. My today's video session is regarding optimal binary search tree and its solved example for four nodes. Before that, I would like to give you a shortcut link for the introduction of binary search tree. I am providing that shortcut link in this right up corner. In this video, you will get all the basic information introduction about optimal binary search tree. Now I consider all of you are knowing what is optimal binary search tree. So optimal binary search tree is basically binary search tree, and binary search tree is used or mainly constructed for searching purpose, searching any key from it. For searching any key from a binary search tree, it should take some optimal time is our requirement. Because if our tree is skewed binary tree, it will take more time to search the leaf node in that skewed binary tree. Instead of that, if I'll convert that tree in different way where it will take the optimal time to search any of the key from it, then that tree is called as optimal binary search tree. So to take optimal time to search any key, for this we need to construct a binary search tree in such a way that it should take optimal time to search any key from the given BST. And to construct optimal binary search tree, frequency of searching of every key is required. What is frequency? So frequency is nothing but the number of times that particular key is going to be searched in a given binary search tree. So with the help of that frequencies, construction of optimal binary search tree is possible. Now we'll see the methods to construct optimal binary search tree. So to construct optimal binary search tree, the first method is logical method, where we'll apply some logic for the construction of binary search tree, optimal binary search tree. The logic is, if the frequency of node is higher, then that node is, we are going to make it as either root node or a parent node. We'll keep that node at the higher level, and if the frequency is less, then we'll keep that node at the lower level, that is at the child or a leaf level. The second method is, practically we can construct the optimal binary search tree by applying some formula. So the formula is, weight we need to calculate plus C1, C2, two values we need to take it from the cost matrix to find out the final cost, where J, from this formula, J is nothing but the key number which is currently root node. WT is also its weight for IJ, and M is a current root node. I'll explain all these things once we are going to use further the formula in my this video. Now let's start with the solved example, where I have taken these four nodes, 11, 22, 33 and 44. Their key numbers are 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively, with their frequencies 4, 2, 6 and 3 respectively. For the construction of optimal binary search tree, if more than two nodes are there, we can use this cost matrix. The cost matrix size will be dependent on the number of keys which we are going to use for the construction of optimal binary search tree. So the size of matrix will be this n plus 1. If the size is 4, that is 4 number of nodes are there, so n plus 1, that is 4 plus 1, 5 by 5 matrix we are going to use. In this matrix, these rows are used as rows, and j are going to indicate the column values. This lower matrix will be as it is, that we are not going to use for putting any value in this matrix. That's why I have indicated these as the gray area. The white area that we are going to update one by one in every step. The very first step is for the construction of optimal binary search tree for zero number of nodes. If I need to construct an optimal binary search tree, for this I need to start from the zero number of nodes. Then I'll go for, if a single node is there, what type of optimal binary search tree can be possible. If the two combination of two nodes are there, what the possibility to construct optimal binary search tree, and so on till n. So n plus 1 number of steps you will require for the construction of optimal binary search tree, because it is starting from 0 number of nodes. For 0 number of nodes, what I'll do, I'll find out n is equal to j minus I is equal to 0. For all j and I whose combination j minus I is equal to 0, for all that values I am going to find out the cost. So now let's see, if my j and I both are 0, that is 0 minus 0 result is 0, yes, I want the same. That's why cost I j is nothing but I is 0, j is 0, so that's why cost 0 is equal to 0. Next is, if my j is 1, I is 1, for this also my result is 0, that's why my cost, the cell is 1, for this also it is 0. First cell was this one, 0, second cell is 1, this cell we are going to find out the cost, that is 0. The next one is 2 is nothing but where my j and I are 2, so cost of 2 is also 0, so this cell is also 0. The last one, 3 is also 0 and 4 is also 0. Here you can see that all these values are, or all these cells are diagonal cells, and all these are 0. Why all these are 0? Because the number of nodes are 0. 0 number of nodes means the tree is null tree. For this the cost is always 0. So that's why these all these diagonal values are 0. So after putting these values in my cost matrix, the cost matrix will look like this, where these pink colored cells, they I am going to indicate as these cells, we just calculated the values for this and we have inserted all these values in my cost matrix. Now let's go forward for if one number of nodes, single node if I am going to consider for the construction of optimal binary search tree. Now this is my tree, this is my cost matrix which we have generated in the previous step, that is step 0. Now step 1, where a single node I am going to consider for the construction of optimal binary search tree. For this, what I'll do, I'll find out the n is equal to j minus I is equal to 1. For all the combination of j minus I, if it is equal to 1, for this I am going to find out the cost. Now the first way, that is, if j is 1, I is 0, the result is 1, because n is equal to 1, because I am going to find out now the optimal binary search tree for single node. So for this my cost value is, cost of I comma j is nothing but 0 comma 1 is nothing but my frequency 1, because j is nothing but a node about which right now I am talking about. So first key is nothing but my 11 key, and its frequency is 4, frequency 1. So that's why the cost of this 0, 1 is nothing but 4. The same thing, if my j is equal to 2, I is equal to 1, cost is 2 because frequency is 2. The next one, that is 3 minus 2, j is 3, I is 2, so cost of 2 comma 3 is nothing but 6 as far as my frequency table is concerned. And the last one, 4 minus 3, that is cost of 3, 4, the frequency is 3 as far as my frequency table is concerned. So in this way, there are 4 different combination of ij are there with which I'll get the result n is equal to 1. For this, I'll put directly the frequencies. So after putting these values in my cost matrix, the cost matrix will look like this. So my cost matrix where 0, 1, cell number 0, 1 is nothing but 4, 1, 2 is 2, 2, 3 is 6, and 3, 4 is 3. Now let's go forward if I want to form the combination of two nodes. Now from this step, I am going to explain you the construction of optimal binary search tree with both the methods, that is logically constructed optimal binary search tree, and the next slide I'll explain practically, means by applying formula, constructed optimal binary search tree. So now let's go for the logically constructed optimal binary search tree. Now this table will explain, that is n is equal to j minus I, whatever we have done in previous two slides, the same thing I'll do over here. For all the combination of j and I whose subtraction is equal to 2. So there are three possibilities where j minus I is going to become 2 or the result is 2. That is, if my j is 2, I is 0, it will result into 2. If j is 3, I is 1, result is 2. And for j 4 and I 2, result is 2. So for these three possibilities, I can construct or I need to find out a cost. So for 2 minus 0, I need to find out the cost of 0 comma 2 because I is 0, j is 2. Same thing, cost of 1 comma 3 and cost of 2 comma 4. It indicates that the j is going to indicate the key number, that is key number 2. Here, whenever the combination of two nodes are there, always these nodes are in the consecutive position. That is, if key number 2 I am going to consider, it indicates that it always comes with 1. So key number 1 and 2 I am going to consider over here as the first combination of two nodes whose frequency is 4 and 2 respectively. Here j is 3. J is 3 means what? J is equal to 3. It means always it comes with the node 2. So 2 and 3 is the next combination, second combination, that is key 22 and 33 will consider, and their frequency is 2 and 6 respectively. And the last one is j is equal to 4. J is equal to 4 means consecutive two nodes, two keys we are going to consider. It means that 3 and 4 we are going to consider, and here the keys are 33 and 44 with their frequencies 6 and 3 respectively. Now we'll find out what are the possible optimal binary search trees for these two keys. So these are two possible optimal binary search trees. Now all of you are knowing how to find out this total cost. All these things I have already explained in that introduction wala video, where if 11 is a root node, then the value or the cost of root node 11 is nothing but its frequency multiplied by its level is equal to its cost. So cost of node 11 is nothing but 4. Cost of 22 is again 4 because its frequency is 2, its level is 2, 2 2's are 4, that's why the cost of 22 is 4. And the total cost for this particular tree, the first tree, is 8. If two nodes are there, there are two possibilities. Either 11 is going to become a root node or 22 is going to become a root node. From these two trees, I need to find out the optimal one, which is having minimum cost, as the best suitable optimal binary search tree. So for this second tree, the total cost is 10. I'll select the first one as the optimal binary search tree with the minimum cost. So this is going to become my tree, the optimal binary search tree, whose total cost is 8. Now here, the next example we'll see, where the combination of two nodes are nothing but 22 and 33. So two possibilities are there. If root node is 22, if root node is 33, what will be the total cost? Either 14 or 10. From which I'll select this one, because this is nothing but tree who is having the minimum cost, that is 10. So this tree is having the total cost 10, that I am going to select for the combination of 22 and 33. And the last one, 33 and 44, for this combination, for the first tree whose root node is 33, its total cost is 12. For the second tree, the root node is 44, its total cost is 15. For among these two trees, the first one I will select as it is having the minimum cost. So these three trees we are getting for the cost of 0, 2, the total cost is minimum cost is 8. For 1, 3, the minimum cost is 10. And for 2, 4, the minimum cost is 12. Now here how I have used the logic. Now here you can see that the number 11 having the higher frequency among these two. So that's why higher frequency node will be at the root position, lower frequency node will be at the leaf position. In the next 2, 22 and 33, among these, the 33 is having the higher frequency, is at the root node, and 22 is at the leaf node. In the same way, 33 and 44, 33 is having higher frequency, that's why it is at the root node, and 44 at the leaf node. So by applying a logic, we'll come to know that the tree can be constructed if there is a combination of two nodes. This is the first possibility, this one is the second possibility, and this one is the third possibility. Now we'll see by applying formula how we can construct the optimal binary search tree. So optimal binary search tree for the combination of two nodes by applying a formula. For that, this is the previously generated cost matrix we are having. And now let's see what to do. For this, my first two keys, combination of first two keys, that is 11 and 22, for this my j minus I is equal to 2. For that j was 2, I was 0. For this I need to find out the weight of 0, 2. So 0, 2, j is nothing but the node, key position, key number 2. 2 is always comes along with 1, so the frequency of these two node is 4 and 2. I'll perform addition on that, so my weight is 6 I am going to use. Now there are two possibilities, either 11 is going to become a root node or 22 is going to become a root node. So if 11 is a root node, what will be the cost? So for C1, 0, m-1, that is i, m-1, plus C2, m, j, which was our formula. So here, if C1, I means this weight of I am going to use as it is, and m minus 1, C2, m, j. So this C1 ka I and C2 ka j, that will get from the weight matrix, weight value, that is weight I, j. And the rest of thing, that is C2, m is nothing but the root number, key number of the root is nothing but 1, and this is nothing but m minus 1, that is 1 minus 1 is 0. So that's why C1 key value will get from this cost matrix is 0, that is C1 0 0 is 0, and the another value is C2 1, 2. So this 1, 2 is nothing but 2. So 0 plus 2 and the weight we have just calculated is 6, so the cost 1 is nothing but 8. So what does it mean? If my root node is 11, then the cost generated, total cost generated by that optimal binary search tree is 8. If my root is 22, the same thing I'll do. C1 of I and C2 of j, that will get from this weight of I, j. C2 of m is nothing but the root key number, is nothing but 2. 22, its key number is 2. So that's why C2 of m is 2, and C1 of m minus 1, that is m is 2, that's why m minus 1 is 1. So that's why C1 ka this value is 1. So C1 of 0, 1, C1 of 0 and 1 is nothing but 4, this value 4 I'm going to use over here. Then C2 of 2, 2, 2 and 2. So this value 0 I am going to use over here, and plus its weight is nothing but total value is 10. From these two values, the minimum one is this one, means it means that if my root node is 11, it is giving the optimal binary search tree with the minimum weight 8. Now let's go forward for next two keys. If my next two keys are 22 and 33, for the key number 22 and 33, first of all I'll find out the weight. Weight 1, 3. Why it is 1, 3? This one is step 1 if two nodes are there. 3 is nothing but the key number. 3 always comes in hand with 2. So for the frequency, 2 and 6 will perform addition to get the weight of 1, 3. Now again there are two possibilities. Either 22 is going to become a root node or 33 is going to become a root node. If my 22 is a root node, my C1 of I and C2 of j is nothing but weight of ij. Same thing is over here. C1 of I and C2 of j is the same thing, that is weight of ij. The rest of the thing are going to be changed, like C2 of m. Here m is root node is 2, so that's why c2 of m is 2, and this 2 minus 1 is going to become c1 of m minus 1 is 1. So c1 of 1 1 is 0, c2 of 2 3 is 6, and its weight is 8, so that's why total cost 1 is 14. That is, if my root node is 22, the cost is going to become 14 for that optimal binary search tree. And if root is 33, then this c1 value from our cost matrix is 2, c2 is 0, and its weight is 8, so total cost 2 is 10. Among these two, the minimum one is this one. If my root node is 33, it is giving the minimum cost. So I'll select this cost for the root equal to 33 for the combination 1,3, weight 1,3. So this 1,3, this cell, for this cell, I'll select the value 10 as a minimum cost. And the last one, where you can see that for the last two keys, 33 and 44, the weight of 2,4 is nothing but 2 is nothing but the step number 2, 4 is nothing but the key number which comes along with key number 3. So for these two keys, the combination of 33 and 44, the weight is nothing but 9. Sorry, here you are not able to see the things, but you can calculate over here. That is, the frequencies are 6 plus 3, so that's why weight is 9 over here for this combination. C1 of I is nothing but 2, C2 of J is nothing but 4, because here weight of 2,4 we are going to identify. The same thing, C1 of I is 2, C2 of J is 4. The remaining thing is for this root number 3, key number 3, C2 of M is 3 and C1 of M minus 1 is going to become 2. The same thing here for the root number 4, that is key number 4, this C2 of M is 4 and C1 of M minus 1 is 3. For this, if you are not able to see these below values, you can calculate over here from the given cost matrix. C1 of 2,2 is 0, C2 of 3,4 is 3, plus its weight is 9, so total cost is 12. And C1 of 2,3 is 6, C2 of 4,4 is 0, the weight we have already calculated over here is 9, so total cost is 15. Among these two, we are going to select the minimum one. That is, if my root node is 33, the cost is 12, which is minimum cost. So here, the green part, highlighted part, I am going to select as a minimum cost. So for 0,2, minimum cost is 8. For 1,3, minimum cost is 10. And the root node is also we need to keep in mind. And for 2,4, the minimum cost is 12. You can see the same thing we have calculated in previous slide, where we have applied some logic. The root node, if it is 33, it is generating the cost 10 for the second combination, that is 22, 33. For the first combination, 11 and 22, the cost was 8. And for last one, 33 and 44, for the combination, again 33 was a root node with the minimum cost 12. Now I'll put these values in my cost matrix. This was the previous cost matrix. Now for the values I and J, for the combination of two nodes, if my n is equal to j minus I is equal to 2, I need to find out the cost, what is our root node, and what was the key number. So for the first combination, 2 minus 0 is equal to 2, cost of 0,2 was 8 by both the method, where the root was 11 and its key number was 1. For the next combination, cost of 1,3 is nothing but 10. The root node was 33 and key number was 3. For the next combination, cost of 2,4 was 12, the root number was 33 and the key number was 3. Here in these pink cells, I have inserted these values. For 0,2, this is nothing but the cell. For 0,2, the result is 8, and this curly bracket indicates that this is nothing but a root position, which node is a root node, because this was not required for the rest of the values, because for this the root was 1, for this value root was 2, for this root is 3, and for this root is 4. But now for this 8, how we are getting this 8 as a minimum cost? If my 11 is going to become a root node, for this 10, from where we are getting this minimum cost 10? If my root node 3, that is key number 3, that is 33, if my this is root node, then I can get this as a minimum cost. Same thing for 12, if my root node is 33, that is key number 3 is my root node, it indicates that this will be giving the optimal binary search tree. So this was the thing done for the combination of two nodes. Now let's go forward for the next step, where the combination of three nodes, I want to perform it with the help of first method, that is logically, if I want to construct the optimal binary search tree. For this, all n is equal to combination of all j minus I is equal to 3. So there are two combinations can be possible, where 3 minus 0 is equal to 3 and 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. For this, cost of 0, 3 and cost of 1, 4 I need to find out. 3. Now combination of 3 nodes. My j is equal to 3. It indicates that this 3 number node along with its previous two nodes I need to consider, because all consecutive three nodes I am going to consider for the construction of optimal binary search tree. So that's why 11, 22, 33 along with their frequencies 4, 2 and 6 I need to consider. Now here I'll apply the logic. I'll apply the principle where highest frequency number, the node that I'll put at the highest level, the lowest frequency number I will put at the lowest level. By applying this, I will get the combination of the optimal binary search tree. If three nodes are there, so maximum 5 possibilities are there with which I can construct the optimal binary search tree, from which I will select the best one, is nothing but the best one, where 33 is a root node, 22 is its leaf node, and the total cost is 20. For the next combination, the root node is 33. We will select it as 33 because it is having the highest frequency among the rest of 2. So the constructed optimal binary search tree is like this, having a minimum cost 16. So this I have done logically by applying a logic, with the highest frequency number will be at higher level or root level, and the lowest frequency number will be at the lowest level leaf level. Here both nodes are at the same position, because 33 is the middle key to 22 and 44. That's why 22 and 44 are going to become its left child and right child respectively. Now let's apply formula as a second method to find out the optimal binary search tree. This is the cost matrix which we have generated after combination of two nodes. So now these two values we need to find out, 0, 3 and 1, 4, that we have already seen in the previous slide, where n is equal to j minus I is equal to 3. So for this, the combination of three nodes are 11, 22 and 33. So here I need to find out the weight 0, 3. Why it is 0, 3? Because this is the 0th step for the three nodes, and the first three nodes I am going to consider. J is nothing but the key number 3. 3 always comes along with 1 and 2. So 11, 22, 33 ka frequency is 4, 2 and 6. So that's why 4 plus 2 plus 6 is nothing but 12. So for this, the weight is equal to 12 that I am going to use. Now 3 nodes are there with me. So 3 possibilities are there to become a root node. Either 11 is going to become a root node, or 22 is going to become a root node, or 33 is going to become a root node. So if my 11 is a root node, what will be the minimum cost? For this, again I will apply the same formula, that is C1 of I, C2 of j are nothing but weight of ij, they are 0 and 3 respectively. C2 of m is nothing but the key number of a root node, that is 1, and 1 minus 1 is nothing but the C1 of m minus 1 is 0. These values I will get from this matrix, cost matrix, weight is already calculated over here, is nothing but 12. So that's why cost 1 is nothing but 22. If my root node is 22, that is key number 2. So C2 of M is nothing but 2. C1 of M minus 1 is 1. I'll find out the cost from this cost matrix, and the resultant cost 2 is nothing but 22. If my root is 33, C1 of 0 2 plus C2 of 3 3 plus weight, I'll do C2 of M is nothing but 3 because now 33 is a root node. C2 of M minus 1 is nothing but 3 minus 1 is 2. So C1 0 comma 2 is 8 plus C2 3 comma 3 is 0 plus its weight. So total cost is 20. Among these 3, I'll select this as a best one because it is having the minimum weight. So what I'll do, I'll put this cost of 0 3, means this wala sale, I'll put as 20. And the next one, next possibility is like for the next 3 keys, that is weight of 1 comma 4. This one is nothing but the first step. This we have done with the 0th step for 3 node, combination of 3 node, and this is going to become a first step where the next 3 nodes, where the last node is nothing but 4. So 4, 3 and 2, these 3 keys we are going to use or consider for the construction of optimal binary search tree. For this again, there will be 3 different possibilities if 22 is a root node, 33 is a root node and 44 is a root node. By applying the same formula again, we'll get the cost 1 as 22, cost 2 as 16 and cost 3 as 21. Here you can pause the video, you can check whether these calculated values are correct or not, and then how to apply a formula and all these things, and then you can continue with the rest of the video. So from these 3, this cost I will select as a minimum cost where root node is 33. The same thing was done, we have done in the previous video, sorry, previous slide, where the root was 33 with the total minimum cost as 20, and the root was 33 again for the next combination of 3 nodes with the minimum cost as 16. For your reference, we'll go backward and you can see that the for the first 3 nodes as a combination, the cost was 20, where we have constructed this optimal binary search tree by applying a logic. For the next 3 keys, the total cost is 16, minimum cost for the next 3 keys. In the same way, we are getting the values for the first 3 nodes as a combination. We are getting the minimum cost as 20. For the next, we are getting the minimum cost as 16. I'll put these values into my cost matrix. So for the combination of 3 nodes, n is equal to j minus I is equal to 3. I'll find out the cost and the root and its key number. So there are only 2 combinations. Sorry, 2 combinations. 3 minus 0 is equal to 3 and 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So cost of 0, 3 is 20. Cost of 1, 4 is 16. For both the root node was 33 and their key number was 3. I'll put these values into my matrix. This is my previous matrix and now my updated matrix, constructed matrix, or the values after updation are: for 0, 3 value is 20, whose root node is key number 3. For 1, 4 the value is 16, whose root node is 3 again. So in this way, we have constructed optimal binary search tree for the combination of 3 nodes. Now let's go forward for the all 4 nodes. So combination of all 4 nodes, logically constructed tree, that is n is equal to j minus I is equal to 4. For a single combination of j and I is there, who will result into 4, that is 4 minus 0 is 4. So what I'll do, I'll find out a cost of 0 comma 4. Key number are all 4 because j is 4 and a combination of 4 nodes are there, so 4 will come along with 3, 2 and 1. So that's why all 4 keys I'll write down over here, that is 11, 22, 33 and 44, with their frequencies 4, 2, 6 and 3 respectively. Now I'll apply the logic, because now here I'm using this logically constructed optimal binary search tree, where I will put 33 as a root node because it is having somehow the highest frequency. Then I'll go for 11 as a left child of 33 because next is having the highest frequency 4. Then I'll go for the frequency 3 for the node 44, that will going to become as a right child of 33, and the last one 22 will go to the leaf level position. So in this way I'll construct the optimal binary search tree. Its total cost is 26. You can calculate over here, and its total cost is 26. So if I will construct it logically, so I can perform the I can find out the optimal binary search tree. There are different possibilities are there from which this one is the optimal one, who is giving the optimal frequency or optimal time to search any of the node in the given binary search tree. So if I want to search 33, it will take 6 means the after calculating the frequency, the 6 is nothing but the cost to search 33 in my optimal binary search tree. For 11 it is 8, for 44 the total cost is 6 again, for 22 total cost is 6 again. So this, it will take the optimal time to search this all the keys in the given binary search tree. If the same thing I need to find out by applying a formula. So for this I am having this cost matrix which was we have constructed or identified after combination of 3 nodes. Now this is 4 node. This single cell I need to find out for this 4 different combinations I am having. That is 4 keys are there. It means that either 11 is going to become a root node, or 22 is going to become a root node, or 33 is going to become a root node, and the 44 is going to become a root node. For this I need to first of all find out a weight. Weight 0,4. For all the 4 keys I need to find out a weight. Is nothing but 4 plus 2 plus 6 plus 3 is equal to 15. So weight is 15. If root is 1, key number 1, that is 11, so C2 of M is 1 and C1 of M minus 1 is 0. C1 of I and C2 of J are nothing but 0, 4 for all the 4 possibilities. Only the thing is going to be changed is C2 of M and C1 of M minus 1 in all the 4 possibilities. So here applying or putting the values from our cost matrix, we'll get the cost 1 as 31. If root node is 22, that is key number is 2, C2 of M is 2, C1 of M minus 1 is 1. By applying values over here, the cost 2 is 31. If root node is 33, that is key number is 3, C2 of M is equal to 3, C1 of M minus 1 is equal to 2. For this, we are getting the cost 3 is 26, and the last one, if root node is 44, C2 of M is 4, C1 of M minus 1 is 3, and the total cost is 35. From these 4 different combination, if root node is 11, cost is 31, if root node is 22, cost is 31, if root node is 44, cost is 35, and if root node is 33, cost is 26. Among these 4 values, if root node is 33, cost is 26 is minimum. That's why I'll select this one to put into my cost matrix for the position 0, 4. Because I'm finding the value cost for 0, 4. So just put this value into my cost matrix. For the combination of 4 nodes, n is equal to j minus I is equal to 4. For a single combination we are having, we are getting, that is n is equal to 4. For j is equal to 4 minus I is equal to 0. So cost of 0, 4 is 26, where root node was 33 and the key number was 3. So put this value into my cost matrix, that is 26 with the root node 3. I am going to indicate this as a root node because at the end we should come to know that key, this 26 is a minimum cost for which one was the root node. because four different root nodes can be possible at this position if four nodes combination is there. Among these, I am going to select the node number 3, key number 3 as its root node. So in this way we can construct the optimal binary search tree for four nodes. So thank you dear friends for listening my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content of video, please like my video, please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. I am providing you the subscription link over here. Do not forget to share it with your friends, as well as do not forget to keep bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification about my channel. Here I am providing some shortcut links to some of the videos that will be helpful for you. So thank you dear friends, stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks.